Hello friends, in this video I'd like to solve the following problem from the Romanian National Mathematical Olympiad, 9th grade, 1997, problem number 2. We want to find the range of the following function. F of t equals 3 plus 2 times sine of t over square root of 1 minus cosine of t plus square root of 1 plus cosine of t for all real numbers t. It's a nice problem. Here are my hints. It's all about trigonometric identities. The following four identities will be very useful. First, cosine of t can be written as 2 times cosine squared of t over 2 minus 1, and also it can be written as 1 minus 2 times sine squared of t over 2. Likewise, sine of t can be written as 2 times cosine of t times sine of t. Cosine squared of t over 2 plus sine squared of t over 2 is 1, well-known identity, probably the most famous trigonometric identity. And the last one, sine of alpha plus minus beta is sine of alpha cosine of beta plus or minus cosine of alpha sine of beta. And actual hints for this problem. First, our function is periodic, it's clear, because sine of cosine are periodic. So we may assume without loss of generality that t is between 0 and pi of, and 2 pi. And we should consider separately cases where t is between 0 and pi and when t is between pi and 2 pi. And also we should transform our expression to express it in terms of sine and cosine of t over 2. It might be beneficial. So give this problem a try and I will see you in just a minute. Very well. So let's play with our expression. First, our function f of t. So, as I said, first we may assume our function f is periodic of period 2 times pi. So, the image of real numbers is the same as the image of just interval of 0 to pi. So let's concentrate on t from the interval from 0 to pi. So let t be somewhere between 0 and 2 pi. Actually, it can be open on the right hand side. Doesn't really matter, but it can be open. Very well. Now let's transform our expression. So we have f of t equals 3 plus 2 times sine of t, 1 minus cosine of t, plus square root of 1 plus cosine t. Very well. Now, what I will do? What I will do is use a couple of identities. So first, sine of t can be written as 2 times cosine of t over 2 sine of t over 2. And likewise, in the denominator, we have square root of 1 minus, and instead of cosine of t, I can write 1 minus 2 times sine squared of t over 2. And here we have 1 plus, and here I will write 2 times cosine squared of t over 2 minus 1. Now we have 3 plus 4 cosine of t over 2 sine of t over 2. And in the denominator, let's look, we have 1 minus 1, it's 0. So we have square root of 2, square root of sine squared of t over 2, plus square root of 2, and here we have cosine squared of t over 2. So we have 3 plus 4 cosine of t over 2, sine of t over 2. And now, let's take a look. What is square root of square of some number? Well, it's the absolute value. It cannot be omitted. It is the absolute value of sine. It's the absolute value of sine of t over 2. And here we have the absolute value of cosine of t over 2. Perfect. And now let's also remember that we are dealing with t is between 0 and 2 pi. So t over 2 is between 0 and pi. And we know that sine is positive on this interval or non-negative, so we can get rid of one of the absolute values. So here we will have square root of 2 sine of t over 2, but unfortunately we cannot remove the absolute value from cosine, because its sine depends on what quadrant we are in. But we really want to remove this absolute value, and now we will consider separately two cases. Case number one, when t is between 0 and pi over 2, notice that then t over 2 is between 0 and pi, then t over 2 is between 0 and pi over 2, so cosine of t over 2 is definitely greater than 0. It's definitely greater than 0, which allows us to remove our absolute value. So f of t equals 3 plus 4 cosine of t over 2 sine of t over 2, and here we have square root of 2 can be factored out, cosine of t over 2 plus sine t over 2. Very well. Now, I wish to express both the numerator and the denominator in terms of this variable, and I will do a trick. It's a tricky part. First, I will write number 3 as 3 plus 2. And I will write this number 2 as 2 cosine squared of t over 2 plus 2 sine squared of t over 2. It's the tricky part. And the rest stays as it is. Square root of 2 cosine of t over 2 plus sine t over 2. Very well. And now notice that this part, these three terms, can be combined, and we can write 1 plus 2 cosine of t over 2 plus sine of t over 2 squared over square root of 2 cosine of t over 2 plus sine of t over 2. Very well. And now we can do a substitution. So let's substitute, let u be equal square root of 2 cosine of t over 2 plus sine of t over 2. After that substitution, we see that our expression can be written, our function can be written as 1 plus u squared over u. It's a rational function, and we will find the range of this rational function, but we do not yet know the range of u, range of u itself. But now, let's take a look. We can use another trigonometric identities. I can write it as 2 times 1 over square root of 2 sine of t over 2 plus 1 over square root of 2 cosine of t over 2. And that in turn can be written 1 over square root of 2 is cosine of pi over 4. So we have cosine of pi over 4 sine of t over 2 plus, and 1 over square root of 2 is also sine of pi over 4 times cosine t over 2. And now using this little identity that sine of alpha plus beta equals sine of alpha cosine of beta plus cosine of alpha sine of beta, we can write our expression as 2 times sine of t over 2 plus pi over 4. Now, let's also remember that t is between 0 and pi, so t over 2 is between 0 and pi over 2, so t over 2 plus pi over 4 is between pi over 4 and 3 pi over 4. And now, I have made this drawing of sine of 2 times sine of x. So here we have y equals 2 times sine of x, and let's concentrate to the interval, on the interval pi over 4, 3 pi over 4. Let's take a look. Here we have pi over 2, so pi over 4 is right here, and likewise here we have 3 pi over 2, so 3 pi over 4 is right here. Am I right? No, what I'm talking about. No. Here is 3 pi over 4. Sorry about that. Here is pi. Very well, so what's the range? Well, the range is this part. And we see that at pi over 2, the maximum value is 2. And here, at pi over 4, well, sine of pi over 4 is square root of 2 over 2. So twice that, square root of 2. So in other words, that means that our that means that our variable u, let's write it, our variable u is between square root of 2 and 2. Again, what we are doing, we wish to find the range of this function on this interval. Maybe let's write it. We want to find the range of, let's say, g of u, which equals 1 plus u squared over u, where u is between square root of 2 and 2. How can we do it? Well, by differentiation, of course. So g of u, let's see, g of u is 1 over u plus u. Derivative of g is 1 minus 1 over u squared. And notice that this is what? This is greater than 0 because u is greater than or equal square root of 2. Yes? Because u is greater than or equal square root of 2. So here we have, in the denominator, we have 2 or more. So our fraction is definitely greater than 0. So which means that g is strictly increasing. Strictly increasing on the interval square root over 2, square root of 2, 2. So let's find the extreme values. G of square root of 2 is 1 plus 2 over square root of 2. So it's really 3 over square root of 2. And what is G of 2? G of 2 is 5 over 2. Which means that range, so maybe that g range of this is interval 3 square root of 2, 5 over 2. In other words, what I have just demonstrated is that if t is between 0 and pi, the range of our function is B2 is equal to 3 over square root of pi 5 over 2. So it was our first case. We have second case to consider. Case number 2, when t is between pi and 2 pi. Case number 2, t is between pi and 2 times pi. Let's go back to our formula for f of t. F of t, remember, it was 3 plus 4 sine of t over 2, cosine of t over 2, square root of sine of t over 2. But this time, remember that we have absolute value of cosine of t over 2, but this time cosine is negative. So we have to plus, to put minus in front. So it's minus t over 2, yes, because t over 2 is between pi over 2 pi, i.e. cosine t is negative. Very well. And now I wish to do similar trick. I wish to write my numerator in terms of sine of t over 2 minus cosine of t over 2. How can we do it? Well, again, we'll make a trick. We'll make a trick, but this time I will write number 3 as 5 minus 2. And I will use, once again, this well-known identity that sine squared plus cosine squared is always 1. So I can write 5 minus 2 times sine of t over 2 squared plus 4 sine of t over 2 cosine of t over 2 minus 2 times cosine squared of t over 2 all over square root of 2 sine of t over 2 minus cosine of t over 2, just that. And now I can write my numerator as 5 minus 5, 2 times sine of t over 2 minus cosine of t over 2 quantity squared. Here we have square root of 2 sine of t over 2 minus cosine of t over 2. And again, I will make a substitution. I will write that this is 5 minus v squared over v, where v this time is defined as square root of 2 sine of t over 2 minus cosine of t over 2. And again, I wish to find the possible values of v, so I will write it as 2 1 over square root of 2 sine of t over 2 minus 1 over square root of 2 cosine of t over 2, which is 2 times, what exactly? Sine of t over 2 cosine of pi over 4 minus cosine of t over 2 sine of pi over 4, which is 2 times sine of t over 2 minus pi over 4. I'm using this identity that sine of alpha minus beta, sine of alpha, cosine of beta, minus cosine of alpha, sine of beta. Very well, and you know what? Let's take a look once again at the graph of sine function. So here, remember that t this time is between pi, 2 times pi, so t over 2 is between pi over 2 and pi, and if I subtract pi over 4, I am between pi over 4 and 3 pi over 4, and once again, here we have pi over 4, here we have pi over 4, pi over 2, 3 pi over 4, once again, here we have square root of 2, here we have 2. So our variable v is once again is once again, v is once again in the interval square root of 2, close on both sides. Very well, and now let's consider this rational function and let's find its range. So we wish to find the range of h of v. Let's say h of v is 5 minus v squared over v. V is between in square root of 2. What's the range of our function? Well, this time there is no need for differentiation. Notice that both the numerator and the denominator, that maybe let's write that notice that function which takes argument from this interval and maps it to 5 minus v squared, this function is clearly decreasing, strictly decreasing, while the function in the denominator, it's just v, yes, v, and it is positive number, this function is increasing. So h itself is also decreasing. Also decreasing, and let's check the extreme values. H of square root of 2, it's 3 over square root of 2. H of 2, h of 2 is 1 over 2, which means that the image of square root of 2 equals 1/2 3 over square root of 2. Very well, and now I need a new page and I will finish my problem. So all in all, I have demonstrated that range of my function f restricted to this interval is 3 over square root of 2 to 1/2. So all in all, maybe let's write it, you know what? We have demonstrated we have demonstrated by now that the image of the interval 0 pi, it was 3 over square root of 2, 5 over 2, if I am not mistaken. And the image of the interval pi to pi is 1/2 3 over square root of 2. So we have our final answer. So the range of our function, which is the range of our function restricted to 0 pi or 2 pi, it is the interval 1 over 2, 5 over 2. And that is our answer. Before you go, I have made a drawing of our function. If you are curious how our function looks like, it looks like that. And as you can see, it really is the case that our range is from 1/2, which is right here, to 5 over 2, which is attained right here. So it's all well and good. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.